Hi everybody, Patrick here from www.electroniclessons.com and www.engineeringshock.com. We have some new supercapacitors in stock. They're used 2600 farad 2.5 volt capacitors. We sell them in lots of 1, 5, and 10. Obviously, the more you buy, the more you save. So have a look at our store. Our eBay store can be found through electroniclessons.com. Anyway, today, nothing new. You saw my 12.5 volt 96 farad capacitor bank powering my TV. I power something different, but we don't have a whole lot of stuff in the apartment that's going to consume a lot more power, except for maybe the blender. Anyway, this bank, I believe, is about 520 farads at 12.5 volts. It's charged to about 12.4 volts. As you can see, I've got my inverter. I've got my Xbox 360, and I'm going to power my TV. Last time we got about maybe 20, 30 seconds out of it. Let's see how long we have this time. Now, from the time it starts to charge at around 12.4 volts, when it gets down to 10 volts, it's going to stop. So, we'll power the TV for as long as it takes down to get down to 10 volts. Now, keep in mind that we're not completely discharging the capacitors. We're only actually getting rid of about 15% of the charge because the inverter is stupid and it quits at that point in time. However, you can't really blame it. Anyways, sorry, that was my kitty. Right now, I've got the inverter plugged into my TV. We're going to play a game. So, first of all, let's plug it in. Expect the spark. That's just the inverter being a jerk. Okay, TV on. Okay, TV on. Oh yeah. 12 volts still. We're playing Dead Rising 2. So let's see how long we can kill zombies for. It's at 12.0 volts. It's been at 12.0 volts for a while. It's just going down to 11.9. Oh yeah. Powering AC with your supercapacitor bank. Now keep in mind our TV is taking quite a bit of wattage here. This is a 400 watt inverter. On its own, even if it's not plugged into anything, it takes up about 400 milliamps. So by now, or if my first bank, 96 farads, 12.5, but would have died actually a while back. So right now, if you've never played Dead Rising 2, great game. Not as frightening as the first one, but a lot more fun, I think. Actually, they're both pretty good. Anyway, we're at 11.5 volts. Keep in mind that it will die at 10 volts. And then, of course, we'll charge it back up with the trusty supercapacitor charger box that can be found by watching some other videos. I've got lots of supercapacitor videos. We sell supercapacitors in our store ranging from 5.5 volts at one farad. We've got 20 farad, 50 farad, 120 farad, 200 farad, 400 farad, 2600 farads, and 3000 farads. And they're all, the more you buy, the more you save. So right now we're at 12.2 volts. I'm very impressed that we've been able to power our TV for this long. And the great thing is, we can still power our radio for probably about 10 hours with the remaining charge on these capacitors. And I'm not kidding, full volume. We can do some awesome stuff with this. Not just killing zombies. And for if any of you out there have been watching The Walking Dead, great show. I suggest if you're not watching, you should give it a chance because it's epic, and you never know, one day, what are you going to do when the dead come back to life and start looking for you and your family? It's going to be epic. I don't know. Uh-oh. Okay, so 10.6 volts. I'm going to run up the stairs. 10.5 volts. We got our warning. 10.4 volts. Oh, the epic countdown begins. How many more zombies can I kill? 10.4 volts. 10.3 volts. Ah, crap. Okay, I don't know how long we got there. But, I don't know. 4 or 5 minutes, maybe? About that. Pretty epic. I'm actually going to stop. I can actually feel the vibration in my Xbox 360 controller telling me that I'm getting eaten alive by zombies. So I'll just turn off my game. I've already beaten it twice. Anyway, this is, again, a 2600 2.5 volt capacitors in series, so 520 roughly farads at charged up to 12.4 volts, and now they're at about 10 volts. So we've literally lost, again, less than 20% of the charge. The inverter quits at 10 volts, unfortunately. Now keep in mind, that's supposed to be being used by, say, a car battery or something like that. However, you get a bunch of these in series, you can boost your car. I'm serious. And these things are being used in electronic cars these days. I mean, well, they will be. I know that they're used in some. But anyway, these are slightly used. Excellent price, discount price. Again, the more you buy, the more you save. We ship to Canada and the U.S. Too many problems shipping overseas, so probably not. You're probably not going to have too much luck for me if that is the case, unless you want to pay for tracking. Anyway, Canada, the U.S., you get tracking no matter what. Excellent deal. Have a lot of fun with them. I can give you some tech support and charging tips. I'll even throw in an LM317 kit and some power resistors to help you charge this. So thanks again for watching, guys. I appreciate it. Visit www.electroniclessons.com and www.engineeringshock.com. Kill some zombies.